who has had a rougher last 6 months, Terry Francona, Hugh Jackson, or Tyronn Lue, talk about two coaches and a manager who could use a group hug. Francona's team torpedoed a 102 win that included an historic 22-game winning streak, by blowing a 2-0 lead to the Yankees in the division series, losing 3 games in a row and getting eliminated by losing the 5th and deciding game, with ace Corey Kluber on the mound, at home. 4 months later, on the first day of spring training, Francona lost his father, Tito Francona, who at the age of 84. Jackson etched his name forever in the NFL's Hall of Infamy by coaching the Browns 2-0-16, forcing him to make good on a promise made after his team went 1-15 in 2016, that if the Browns didn't win a game in 2017 he would jump in Lake Erie. They didn't, and Jackson still hasn't. As the coach of the team that employs LeBron James, who at age 33 is having a career year, Lou would seem to be residing on easy street, but there's been nothing easy about the last 6 months for the Cavs coach. That includes a video that made the rounds on Friday of Lou and LeBron yelling at each other on the Cavs bench during the loss to Portland on Thursday night. That began with the Cavs foolishly caving into Kyrie Irving's trade request, which cost Lou his all-star point guard. The trade blew up in the Cavs' face when injured Isaiah Thomas apparently caused more trouble than he was worth, helping to trigger a nearly unprecedented mid-season roster blow-up, the aftershocks of which are still reverberating through the organization, not to mention the one-loss column. If all that wasn't bad enough, Lou's health was even worse. He's missed games, and parts of games due to undisclosed illnesses. Thanks to a ridiculous run of injuries, he's currently coaching only the shell of the team he's supposed to coach. What's left of the Cavs has made many recent games look more a shoot-around by a bad G League team. Other than that, it's been all seashells and balloons for the three men who run Cleveland's three sports franchises. Let's examine the current situations individually of Hugh, Lou, and Tito too. Francona underscore given his track record for success and the Indians' penchant for stability, it's fair to say that he will be the Indians' manager for as long as he wants the job. And why not? Francona has a higher career winning percentage as a manager, 0.538, than Joe Torre, Tony La Russa, and Tom Lasorda. Francona's 0.606 career postseason winning percentage ranks third among all managers in history with 3 or more postseason appearances. Francona, whose teams have reached the playoffs in 8 of the last 13 years, has more career wins as a manager, 1,483, than Al Lopez, Earl Weaver and Miller Huggins. In Francona's 5 years as manager of the Indians, they have won more games than any team in the American League, 454. That's 22 more than runner-up Boston. And in those 5 years, as Hall of Fame writer Peter Gammons points out, the Indians' combined payroll was $414 million less than the Red Sox. Translation, the Indians have a Hall of Fame manager who is delivering the goods. Jackson underscore, no matter what he accomplishes in his career going forward, Jackson's greatest career achievement will live in the annals of Survivor Dom forever, not being fired after going 0-16 last year and 1-31 in his 2 years on the job. Truly a heartbreaking work of staggering genius. But the Browns are eventually going to start playing games again, and Jackson better start winning some right out of the gate, or else new general manager John Dorsey will be afforded the courtesy most general managers are afforded, the right to hire his own head coach. In other words, Jackson is on the clock, and it is ticking swiftly, my friend. Liu underscore, I would argue that no coach or manager in professional sports is saddled with more pressure or a bigger challenge this year than Tyronn Jamalu. His team includes the greatest player in the world and the hardest player in the world to coach. And it's the same guy. Liu also works for a famously impatient, at times meddling owner, who unfortunately is not exactly on bro hug terms with his greatest player, who can leave as a free agent after this. Liu also works under a rookie general manager who traded half the team at mid-season in a caboodle of deals that seemed to be working until everyone got hurt or lost interest. Liu's job is to drag the whole mess across the finish line, get to the finals, beat the Warriors, and convince LeBron to stay. No wonder the guy's a wreck. Contact Jim Ingraham at 329-7135 or jingraham4@gmail.com.